the UK Ministry of Justice released a report in 2020 about the prison population in the UK. It states that the number of people serving life sentences in England and Wales has more than doubled since 1993. But when does life really mean life? When giving a life sentence to a convict, the judge will specify the number of years that need to be served before that person can apply for parole. Although this does not mean that the convict is guaranteed to be released, this decision is down to the parole board to decide when the minimum term has been reached. But there are exceptions to this, and the judge is able to specify a whole life tariff, meaning that that person will never be released from prison. Crimes that are recommended for a full life tariff are as follows. The murder of two or more persons, where each murder involves any of the following. A substantial degree of premeditation or planning. The abduction of the victim, or sexual or sadistic conduct. The murder of a child, involving the abduction of the child, or sexual or sadistic motivation. Murder done for the purpose of advancing a political, religious, or ideological cause. Murder by an offender that has previously been convicted of murder. At present there are 75 people serving a whole life tariff in the UK, and here are just 25 of them. Michael Smith. In 1976, Smith strangled to death his 18-year-old girlfriend Sheila Deacon, after an alleged argument about his sexual ability. He was given a life sentence, but was released in 2005 after serving 29 years. In 2006, just months after he was released from prison, he murdered 35-year-old Peter Summer, attacking him with a broken bottle, at his home in Stoke. He stole over £8,000 from his victim, and took his girlfriend on a spending spree. He was convicted, and given a full life tariff. Joanne Dennehy. Known as the Peterborough Ditch Murders, Dennehy was convicted of murdering three men. These were Lucas Slabosvevsky, 21. John Chapman, 56. And Kevin Lee, 48, and dumped their bodies in a ditch. She was also charged for the attempted murder of two other men, after picking them out at random in the streets. Her sentencing was delayed until the 28th of February 2014, when she was jailed with a whole life tariff, making her one of only three women to ever be handed a whole life sentence. Mark Bridger. Bridger was arrested and charged for the murder of 5-year-old April Jones, in Machynlleth, Wales, and was found guilty on the 30th of May 2013. He told police that he accidentally ran her over with his car, and that he could not remember where he had hidden her body. Although April's body has never been found, police found bone fragments and blood in Bridger's house that matched April's DNA. John Childs. Childs is an infamous contract killer who was convicted in 1979 for the murder of six people, including a police superintendent. Although none of the bodies have ever been found, he confessed to them after being arrested for a series of bank and security van robberies. In an attempt to get a lesser sentence, he implicated two others who were convicted in 1980, but they were both released on appeal in 2003, after his evidence was found to be fabricated. John Duffy. Known as the railway rapist and railway killer, Duffy attacked and raped numerous women and children, in the south of England, between 1982 and 1986. He murdered three of them, before the police finally tracked him down with the help of psychological profiling. He was sentenced to 30 years for two murders, and seven rapes. After serving 12 years in prison, he admitted to a third murder and named David Mulcahy as his accomplice, and his sentence was increased to life. John Cooper, known as the Bullseye Killer, after his appearance on the game show, helped police to identify him as the killer in two cold cases. He was convicted in May 2011 of two double murders in Pembrokeshire. In 1985, he murdered a brother and sister before setting fire to their house to destroy evidence. In 1989, he murdered husband and wife, Peter and Gwenda Dixon, whilst they were walking along a coastal path. He was also convicted of over 200 burglaries and the rape and sexual assault of two teenage girls. Stephen Port. Known as the Grindr killer, he murdered at least four young men that he met on the gay dating app, as well as committing multiple rapes on others. In 2014, he lured 19-year-old escort Anthony Walgate to his flat, pretending to be a client. When he arrived, he gave him the date rape drug GHB, and dumped his dying body outside his flat, before calling police anonymously to tell them he had had a seizure. He was charged with perverting the course of justice for lying about his involvement, and given an 8-month prison sentence before being released on tag. He then went on to murder at least another 3, and making it look like they had committed suicide. These were Gabriel Kavari, 22, Jack Taylor, 25, and Daniel Whitworth, 21. He was arrested and charged, and on the 25th of November 2016, he was sentenced to a whole life order, and was told he will never be released. Stephen Griffiths. Known as the Crossbow Cannibal, he was convicted of murdering 3 sex workers in Bradford in 2010. One of the murders involved the use of a crossbow, and he was captured on CCTV showing off to the camera, before dragging one of his victims back into his flat. He dismembered all 3 of victims, before dumping their remains in the River Aire. He also claimed to have eaten parts of his victims, but this has never been proven. Robert Maudsley. Maudsley is known as Hannibal the Cannibal and is a serial killer who killed 4 people. He was convicted of killing 1 man in 1970 and given a life sentence. The other 3 of these murders were committed since being in prison. He also claimed to have eaten part of the brain of one of 3 men that he killed in prison, but prison staff told the media this was untrue. He has served most of his sentence in solitary confinement, in a glass cell to prevent him from killing any more inmates. Mark Hobson. In July 2004, Hobson murdered his 27-year-old girlfriend Claire Sanderson at their home. He then lured her twin sister Diane to the home, and then killed her too. He fled and then broke into the home of elderly couple, James and John Britton, a few miles away, where he battered them with their walking sticks, then stabbing them both to death. He then went on the run, but was arrested not long after. He was given a life tariff in 2005. Douglas Vinter. In 1996, he was convicted of the murder of a 22-year-old train worker Carl Eden, and was sentenced to 9 years. He was released on license and met his wife Anne White. In 2008, he strangled and stabbed her to death at her mother's home in Teesside, and was sentenced to a whole life tariff. He appealed his sentence in the UK and through the European Court, but was rejected. Jeremy Bamber. In 1985, Bamber shot dead his adoptive parents along with his sister and twin nephews at the family's home in Essex, in order to claim a 6-figure inheritance. He tried to fool police into thinking his schizophrenic sister had committed the murders, but this was unsuccessful, and Bamber was charged with all 5 murders. His trial judge told Bamber that he found the idea of ever seeing Bamber free again difficult to foresee, and advised that he should serve at least 25 years. At least one Home Secretary has told him that his life sentence would mean life. Michael Adebalajo. On the 22nd of May 2013, British soldier Lee Rigby was attacked and killed by Michael Adebalajo and Michael Adeboale near his barracks in Woolwich. On the 26th of February 2014, after the High Court ruled that whole life sentences were still lawful, provided they were reviewed after 25 years, Adebalajo was sentenced to a whole life term. Adeboale received a 45-year minimum term. Stephen Farrow. Having an obsessive hatred towards Christianity, he was jailed in 2012 for the murder of Reverend Suddards, aged 59, at his vicarage in Bristol. He told police was because he was sexually abused by a clergyman as a child. He also broke into the home of 77-year-old retired teacher Betty Yates in Bewdley, and after beating her with her walking stick, he stabbed her to death. Philip Heggarty. In 2003, aged 47, he beat his friend Derek Bennett to death with a hammer in Cardiff. He then wrapped his body in a rug and put it in a stolen car, before setting fire to it. His face was so severely mutilated that he could only be identified through dental records. He already had 79 convictions for violent assaults, including attempted murder, and was sentenced to a whole life term. He appealed his sentence in 2014 but was rejected by the appeal judges. Stephen Wright. Known as the Suffolk Strangler, he was convicted in 2008 for the brutal murder of 5 sex workers in Ipswich, over a period of 6 weeks. He was sentenced to a whole life tariff. He was to appeal his convictions but decided to drop it months later. He is still being investigated by police in relation to other unsolved murders and disappearances in the area. Rose West. In 1995, West was convicted, along with husband Fred West, of the murder of 10 women and girls in her home in Gloucester. The victims included one of her daughters and a stepdaughter. Her husband Fred West committed suicide in jail before he could be tried for 12 murders. David Baxendale. Having a string of convictions for knife crimes and drug offences, in 2011 he stabbed to death a mother of three, 28-year-old Sarah Thomas in Surrey for refusing to give him a kiss. He fled the country and was arrested and extradited by Spanish police from Fuengirola. It later emerged that he had already served prison time in Spain for the murder of his friend. Rahan Arshad. Having discovered that his wife was having an affair, in April 2006, at their home in Greater Manchester, he beat to death his wife and three children, aged 6, 8 and 11 with a rounder's bat. He fled the country and was arrested weeks later in Thailand and extradited to the UK. He told police that he arrived home to find his wife had killed their three children, and then he beat her to death. All forensic evidence identified him as the killer of all four, and was found guilty by a jury. He was sentenced to life, and the judge told him in this case, life means life. Desmond Lee. In 1989 in Bradford, he was convicted of the murder of his landlady Shirley Carr, after he alleged she taunted him because his boyfriend had ended their relationship. He denied murder, but was found guilty and was sentenced to life, but was released on license in 2004. Whilst still on license, in 2009 he murdered a 51-year-old civil servant after meeting him in a gay sauna. His naked body was discovered by a jogger 11 days later, dumped on moorland near Huddersfield. He was sentenced to life and was told he will never be released. Lee Newell. In 1998 he was convicted of killing his 56-year-old neighbour Mary Neal in Norwich. He was sentenced to life. In 2013, whilst serving his sentence at HMP Long Larton, he murdered convicted child killer Subhan Anwar with a sharpened toilet brush handle. He was given a second life sentence and will never be released. Viktor Dembovskis. In 2005, Latvian immigrant Dembovskis murdered 17-year-old schoolgirl Jeshma Raithatha. She was repeatedly raped and stabbed in the heart on her way home from school. He fled the UK and was arrested in Latvia and extradited. He was charged with her murder, and it emerged that he had already been convicted and jailed for a number of rapes in Latvia before he moved to the UK. He was given a whole life tariff. Unable to cope with the death of her sister, 12-year-old Nishma committed suicide by jumping from a car park. Mark Robinson. In 1979, when he was just 17, he strangled 33-year-old Patricia Wagner to death at her home in Billingham. Her lifeless body was discovered by her 8-year-old son. He was sentenced to 10 years and was released in 1989. Just 7 months after being released, he stabbed his new 25-year-old girlfriend Sharon Morley to death, because he found a photo of her ex-boyfriend and he became jealous. He was sentenced to life and was told he will never be released. Since being at HMP Wakefield, Robinson has put 5 prison officers in hospital, and is considered one of the most dangerous prisoners in the UK. Dale Cregan. In 2012, 29-year-old grenade and gun maniac Cregan killed 2 female police officers, Nicola Hughes and Fiona Bone, after they responded to a 999 report of burglary in Greater Manchester. The caller was actually Cregan, who was luring both of his victims to their death. He opened the door and immediately fired 32 shots at him, killing them both. He was under investigation at the time for the murder of father and son Mark and David Short, but had been released on bail. During the trial for killing the 2 officers, he admitted to the other 2 murders also. Ian McLoughlin. In 1984, McLoughlin was jailed for 10 years for manslaughter after he hit Len Delgatti over the head with a hammer. In 1992, he murdered a barman Peter Halls and was sentenced to life with a minimum of 25 years. He was released in July 2013, and on the day of his release, he tried to rob an elderly man. The man's 55-year-old neighbor tried to intervene, and McLoughlin slit his throat and he died. He was immediately sent back to prison and will never be released. What do you think about this case? If you would like to join in the discussion, please leave your comments down below, but remember to keep it respectful for the victim's family. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you like true crime stories, please subscribe to my channel, as I upload new content twice per week. Also, don't forget to turn on the notification bell to be notified when I upload. Before you go, why not check out some of my other true crime videos? I have also created several playlists, which make videos easier for you to find, by the subjects that you are interested in. If you have any suggestions for future videos, please let me know.